watching a brand new episode of Learn with Pradeep. Hope all the members and subscribers who have been in India, who is residing in India or have been in India for the last 9-10 days had been enjoying Navratri in India. And yesterday it was Dasera, which was the celebration of good over evil. We also celebrate Vijayadashami, and I guess everybody had a wonderful Durga Puja, Navratri and Vijayadashami celebrations at your place. We wish you all the very best, and may the Almighty give you all the blessings that is needed and shower you with all the dreams that you have in your life. In this particular episode, I'm going to show you how easily you can create a day and night simulation of your design in Microsoft PowerPoint. Let us see how it happens. So I have this particular design of a fictitious sports shoe ad, Nova Air, where you have this person floating on air, and it is actually promoting a particular sports shoe brand called Nova Air. So let's hop back to our designing mode in PowerPoint. So you can see I just have two slides over here, one day slide and one night slide. This is very easy to create this particular design. Where did I get this particular image? Let us check this fantastic site called unsplash.com, and I have searched for people which they have given good amount of people over here. And if I scroll down, here is my particular image which has been photographed by Patricia Palma, and I took this particular image and hopped back to my Photoshop. So in Photoshop, you can actually use your pen tool to select this particular model out from the background, or else you can use the select tool and go to subject. If you click on select tool and subject, you will see within seconds Photoshop's unique artificial intelligence selects the entire boundary of this model from the picture. So over here you will see there is a small glitches of selection over here that you have to manually select with your either the magic wand tool or the selection within your lasso tool, or you can have your quick selection tool. So with that, you can select these areas and you can actually copy and paste in a new layer like the one I have done. Once that is done, you can go and export this particular image as PNG. So once the PNG is done, now it is extremely easy to create the slides. I will show you the first slide, how to create it. You can similarly create the second slide as well. What we need to do, we have to first select one background image, which is very easy. You need not to go anywhere else. You need not to take the images for anywhere, but you can just go to pictures and click on stock images. And you can just say sky. See the humongous amount of sky that this particular image bank has. I had selected this particular sky, so I will stick to this particular sky. I click on that and say insert. See, so this particular sky has come over here. I have to just stretch it a bit, hold shift and stretch this image a bit. Perfect. I can crop it as well. Perfect. So it particularly fits very well in the 16:9 ratio of my slide size. I right click on it and say format picture. In the picture, I will go to transparency and I can dictate the transparency that I want. Okay, so this is the transparency I wanted. So that here it is. Now I will go to insert pictures, this device, and I can just select the transparent image that I have just created, PNG, and download in the screen. Well, great. So now I will crop this image. Great. And then I will scale this image a bit. Lovely. Next thing I need to do is I have to write this text. For the time being, for the sake of time, I will just copy this text from here and I will paste it. Well, this needs to go at the back. So send to back. Oops, it goes totally back. So we cannot use send to back. We'll right click and we'll say send backward. So one step backward and it is there. Great. Now the second part of the thing, which is your 3D shoe that I have used over here and a circle as a shape. Great. So for the circle, it's just the circle's shape that we need. Great. But this also needs to go a bit back. Lovely. Now, how do we get these 3D objects? Worry not, because PowerPoint itself has a good stock 3D models that you can obviously take. Go to stock 3D and you search for sports shoes or shoes. Lovely. So I have taken this particular shoe from here. So I will take that. See now. Now you can have various angles of this particular shoe. So for our design, I had taken this angle, so I will stick to this angle. So your design is done in that way. Also, these particular things that I have added as benefits or the specifications of we can take it and paste over here. Great. Lovely. And also, these two things are images. These are clips which you can also insert from PowerPoint itself. Just click on these icons and you can just search for night and see, you have your icon over here. So I clicked on this and I got these icons over here. So I will just copy these icons and a divider and place it right over there. Lovely. Now I need to copy this and paste this slide again as it is. The background I have to replace, right? So I just delete the background. Again, go to pictures, stock images, and I search for night sky. Great. So let's see which night sky I took last time. Oh, this one is the one I took. So I take the night sky perfect. Obviously, I have to push this to the back. Lovely. Great. And there are certain other things that I also need to do. I click on the night sky, go to format picture, go to image, transparency. Again, I manipulate as per what I want. Great. So this icon over here is not getting displayed properly. So I click on this. I can change it to white icon. Lovely. This divided also. Okay. Lovely. The sports shoe over here in this particular screen can also have a so this we can change. I will just pick up a color from the image itself so that this is a bit little bit visible. You can take a bit lighter color also. And I can change this to text to white so that so now these two are our new slides, these three and four. Great. Now selecting these two things, first we have to go to transition and select morph if it is not already selected. Okay, and let us now click on the third slide and click on slideshow. What happens if I click? It goes to the next slide. There is a 3D rotation that has happened and the background has changed. All the elements of the screen has changed to a night mode. But now if I click on this, it goes and ends the slides. How can we do something that we restrict click on all the aspects, all the area of the screen, and only when we click on the icons over here, then only the transition will happen. So let us see what we can do to get that effect. Great. So first of all, understand that we have to have this action in real action. Okay, this action icon is very important for this particular case. I will click on this icon, the moon icon, moon and star icon over here, and go to action. Over here in the hyperlink, I will have to click to our slide 4. Right, this is the slide 4 where we want to go. And over here, you can also click on this highlight click. Okay. The sun, again, I will go and click on action and select slide 3 from here if it is not selected. How we will select? We can go to slide and select slide 3. Okay. And by default, click on this highlight click. In the second one, you have to click on again the moon icon, go to action, hyperlink to slide number 3. The sun icon, again go to action, highlight click and select the hyperlink to slide number 3. Okay, so for moon the action is for slide number 4, and for the sun the action should go to slide number 6. So now if we click in the moon and the sun icon, you will see that the transition happens. But how to restrict the rest of the transition to happen? So I will click this entire image in the background, and I will click on action. Ensure that it is selected none over there, and highlight click is selected. Similarly for the person, action none, highlight OK. For this no vertex, again action none, highlight click. Sports shoes, again none, hyperlink click. Even for the 3D shoes, same none and hyperlink click, highlight click. The circle also goes the same way, highlight click, and all other elements in the screen, so that if the user clicks on any one of these objects, the movement to next slide will not happen. Okay, great, perfect. Similarly for the second slide also, we have to do the same thing, none. So we are done. Now let us see. Let us go to slide number 3 and start play. If I click over here, nothing happens. The screen is as it is in its place. It is not moving anywhere. If I click on this guy, nothing is happening. Now only if I click on the night mode, see what happens. There's a 3D rotation of the shoe in display, that happens. The background changes to the starry night, and the entire screen reflects as if it is in that night mode. If I now again click on the sun, again this 3D rotation happens and the screen changes to morning or sunlight. It's so easy to create these things, and within seconds you can create amazing effects using just Morph tool and a little bit of innovation. But also remember, for this type of effect, so that this presentation does not move to the next slide, you have to make the backgrounds and the other part of the text inert or do nothing while on click. So that's all, folks. See you in the next episode with some amazing innovative art and innovative trainings pertaining to design thinking, pertaining to PowerPoint, pertaining to visual thinking, Photoshop, so on and so forth in Learn with Tridip. If you have liked this particular episode, please like, share and comment on this episode. And if you are new to this channel, kindly subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you can get all our upcoming notifications. Till we come again with another awesome episode. Goodbye and God bless.